This is my first time.
What? I'm dating a bond trader.
The weird thing is, I still don't remember giving you my phone number.
Information, it's like money. It's all out there for the taking. Jennifer, I want to let you in on a little secret. The secret to all success on the street. You interested? Money is like manure. It's no use to anyone.
Unless it's spread around.
Jennifer, meet Sarah.
Hello. Pleased. So, this is where you start that climb up the ziggurat.
Sarah thinks that I lust for power.
That and other things. Nice meeting you.
Me too.
Call me.
She's an old friend.
So do you?
Do I what?
Lust for power.
Cal.
Looks like this place is filled with old friends.
I managed that guy's account for 5 years. 200% profit, and I can't even get him on the phone.
Maybe you figured your apartment's too crowded.
Yeah, I heard that.
Cal, up and down the street, HSD Capital's all anyone's talking about.
Well, it's just a temporary situation. We move into our new digs tomorrow.
Well, it takes guts. And truth be told, that's my second favorite organ on a man.
So did you really sell them?
Huh?
The Brazilian bonds.
Yeah, sure.
It's in the Rocky Brothers, right? That's right.
Can we just...
Tell me about them.
I'm a little busy right here.
2% interest?
Are you serious? Yeah, subordinated to A&B Ventures.
Amazing. Tell me more.
S&P downgraded them twice last year.
More.
Defaulted 3/4 straight.
Stop.
No. You want muties? I've got tons.
What was that?
What?
Rats. Oh, I hate the West Side.
No. There's no rats. Do you know how much I paid for this? Okay.
Working late, and then I heard you guys come in. I'm sorry. I'll just, you know.
What is just my partner?
Happy for you.
T-bill stories out the wazoo. Don't let me get started on treasuries.
Something, huh?
Who would have thought?
Certainly not me, that's for sure. It'll be cool, right?
Sure, that's a piece of cake. No, it's like the great man said,
debt is a great motivator.
Which great man are we talking about?
Me.
Great.
Come on.
Later.
Yeah,
you got enough romance there? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. This is really good. What the? Excuse me. Have you seen this thing? It's unbelievable.
Yeah, actually, this is my office.
You know, one time at Barnum and Bailey, Bolo pulled a quarter from my ear.
Bolo?
The clown? Duh. Anyway. I thought that was cool, but this, forget about it.
Considering this is my first day in my new office and far be it for me to be rude to anyone, I wonder if you wouldn't mind telling me just who the hell you are.
Oh, I see you've met Josh.
Kaplan, at your service.
Oh, great. And I'm sure that Josh has good reason to be camped out in my office on the first day of the rest of my life.
Absolutely. He's our attorney. First line of defense in the hopefully frivolous lawsuit tossed in our direction by Meriwether Marks. Conference room at 10.
And tell me, why'd that damn clown stop at a quarter? I mean, if he moved up to bills, he wouldn't have to walk around with a red nose and goofy shoes.
Yeah.
Mr. Boyd? I'm sorry to keep you waiting.
I appreciate you seeing me on such short notice.
Sure. Your resume is quite impressive. Unfortunately, we don't have any openings at this time.
Well, I'd be willing to enter your training program.
Sorry.
An hour ago, you said that I...
Sorry to waste your time.
He called you, didn't he?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Near the guys of Brighton or Cheswick.
I'm sorry.
Josh worked for the government 3 years, just hung out his own shingle. His brother and I roomed together freshman year.
I've got a bud down at Dalton and Connolly in D.C.
Oh, sure. Give him a call. See if you can get us skins tickets. Look, it's not that difficult a concept, folks. Goliath decides to get a little testy with David. The townsfolk scatter.
And why aren't you with them?
Well, could be that places like Meriwether give me a terminal dose of... Ajita. In any case, I do understand the ramifications of a TRO. That's temporary restraining order, folks. For those of you who haven't thumbed yet through your Black's Law Dictionary recently.
Bottom line, Mr. Kaplan.
Josh. At the stroke of 9:30 a.m. Thursday, I have to appear before Judge Rubidoux and convince her that the lot of you did not, in fact, walk out of Meriwether Marks with a briefcase full of irreplaceable trade secrets. If you choose to retain me, that is.
Best case?
Life is beautiful. You pay me a decent sum, then go your merry way, making gobs and gobs of money.
Worst case?
You close up shop immediately. Oh, then we get into damages, compensatory and punitive, and then maybe 5-6 years in bankruptcy court.
Where's my tea? No tea? You guys know I love tea.
Tell you what, Josh. We're going to discuss this. We'll get back with you.
Hey, take your time. You got, what, 48 hours?
Decker's Law. Never trust a lawyer you can afford.
Look, it's not like we've got a lot of choices, okay?
Good.
All right, now on to the real business.
Right. Like the phones.
The installed Tuesday?
My question, who are we going to call? Because as of last night, we can add Knapp and Eckberg to the growing list of ex-clients.
Gwen?
And her sister, Gert.
That's the Kaiser, you know? He's got his hands around our throats, and he is squeezing as hard as he can.
Hey, you all knew at the get-go. If it was easy, everyone would do it.
Thank you. Now, I'm sure even our country's forefathers got discouraged. But if I'm not mistaken, we're not exactly drinking warm beer and eating shepherd's pie.
At least they had tea to dump into the harbor.
Oh, hey, sorry, you know, but the lady is funny, huh?
Thank you, Daddy.
Hey, my pleasure. Not that I'm picking, but has anyone else noticed that we are one body short this morning?
He'll be here.
It's not like I enjoy saying I told you so.
So don't.
Okay, good news. I got a friend at the UN tells me Castro's getting out of the hospital.
Wonderful. One more person who won't take my call.
I didn't know Castro was sick.
Those who follow sugar futures know everything about the man.
Sugar.
Sugar.
Didn't Freddie pick sugar last week?
Last week, Freddie was wrong. This week...
Crapshoot.
I'm sorry, it's not as exciting as the Brazilian bonds. Anyway, when it looked like Fidel was going to kick, the entire sugar-buying world thought there'd be a whole new supplier.
Which knocked the price down.
Exactly. And if my info's correct, the price will shoot back up.
Now, all we need is a client.
Actually, I was thinking we could buy it for our own account. It's half the reason we did this thing, right?
That's the attitude I'm talking about here, guys. We roll the pepperoll profits into sugar futures, keep the electricity on for another couple of months. All those opposed? Good.
I'm on it.
So, you know, what's that go for, sugar? See, because I got a cousin, Pete. Now, he tells me that gold is the ticket this year. What? I'm sorry. I just, you know... Yeah.
Good morning. Morning, Hunter.
Lapsang Souchong? No sugar?
Vive la revolution.
That was a late night, Hunter.
No, actually, an early morning. I was on the phone with Bangkok. We're representing Wesley Industries in a divestiture of their electronics division.
Oh, Wesley out of Kansas City?
Yeah, they're with a high-tech plant in Bangkok. Wally Wesley's on the plane today.
Oh, a real-life feat.
If we can find a buyer.
Hey, you know, I call the Rossi brothers. They love high-tech.
The Rossi brothers, didn't they buy the Brazilian bonds?
Yes, they did. And they've already made a 4% profit. Thank you very much.
Ooh, tell me more.
All right, market time, people. Hey, you need me for the heavy lifting on this Wesley thing?
Oh, yeah. Well, as a matter of fact, Al...
Great. All right, let's go grab some grain, people.
Bangkok, right. He was probably knee-deep in a stewardess named Buffy.
What was that supposed to be?
What are you referring to?
The tea. That was totally out of line.
I know you like it.
Yeah, but they don't know you know. And bringing me in on this deal
Al,
is...
look, sue me. I wanted to spend some daylight hours with you. Besides, I need your special talents for this one.
Sure you do.
Al, loosen up. We'll close the Wesley deal. We'll be heroes. And you'll see life through an entirely different window.
Here you go.
Thank you.
And what did I say about the separation of name and face? I don't mean to make mock.
It's
better than I told you so.
Cupboard's still bare, huh?
Six interviews, six callbacks, no gigs. Ah. Kaiser's revenge.
Taking a snooze.
Wrong place, wrong time. What are you going to do?
How'd the wife take it? You didn't tell her. Well, sure. I mean, why upset her? You know, what with the baby doing off?
Yeah, you know, and today I got a desk day trading.
Wait, you day trading?
Way for the future.
Well, you know, that's what I always say. I mean, if it's worth doing, why do it for someone else? You know, it's the old entrepreneurial spirit. Yeah, that's what makes this country great. One of these days you'll see I'll be sitting at the computer next to you.
Isn't it about time for the Kaiser's rounds?
Oh, yeah, right. Like, he'd start without me. I'll see ya.
Hey, today's the day, right?
This is the future. The business of America is business. Calvin Klein said that.
Actually, it was Calvin Coolidge.
Yeah, whoever. The important thing is this is your little piece of the U.S. of A. There is no shame in it.
I guess.
You guess? Hell, you know, this is Vegas without the odds stacked against us.
Thing is, I do not have a disposable income. I've got a kid on the way and next to nothing in the bank.
Well, that's what credit cards are for. It is perfectly safe. I would, however, stay away from Tubby over there. He's what you call high strung.
I thought this wasn't gambling.
It's not. If you do your homework. Now, you take that guy in Atlanta who went nuts after his stock market.
I don't want to know about it.
This is me you're talking to here, Douglas. I've never had a reservation.
I'm sorry.
Okay, well, when Sam Rossi gets here, just tell him I'll be at the bar.
Mr. Rossi is already dining, sir.
I see.
I can't let you in.
What are you doing to me here, Douglas?
I'm sorry, sir.
All right, do me a favor. Would you go tell my grandfather that never mind, okay? Keep up the good work.
There's a shock.
No, it's just because I have a relationship with Wesley.
Well, that's exactly my point. Why am I here, Hunter? Wesley's already retained us.
Well, in so many words, yeah.
You don't have him signed?
I will.
Damn it, you lied to us this morning. Ditto is out trying to convince Sam Rossi to buy something we don't even have the power to sell.
Sometimes you gotta go out on a limb, Al. It's where the food is. Come on.
Now, that's exactly what we need. 5 million shares by next Wednesday. Okay. Thank you. Give me a call. All right.
Rossi wants to sit down on Wesley. His yacht, Pier 22 at 8.
I thought the Kaiser...
I reminded him we hand-deliver those Brazilian bonds.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? Just realized I'm supposed to meet Sarah today. Lecture time.
Well, late dinner is as good a time as any to get KO'd.
Listen, you're going to have to excuse me here, but, well, Dad has put together quite the itinerary for me.
Oh, is Wayne in town?
Kidding, right? Old man likes New York City about as much as a long-tailed cat likes a room full of rockers.
Wesley, lose the corn cob.
Yeah, I know, I know. Hey, look, it worked for the commander-in-chief.
Wesley went to Yale.
Mm. There. How's that?
So, Wallace, we're going to make you a very rich man.
Oh, I'm already a very rich man, Hunter. I've also been thinking long and hard about this deal of yours.
Are you saying you aren't committed to selling?
Committed? Where'd you get that idea? Look, the Bangkok plan is a gold mine. But when someone says he can get me 10 times cash flow, it buys my ear.
But I think that we can stake a claim to an even richer mine.
Well, leave it. I'll review it later with my dad's army of pocket protectors, and then the three of us will talk.
Okay, what about tomorrow night over sirloins?
The steaks I can get back in KC. I was thinking of something a little more esoteric.
Okay. Tomorrow night, then.
So, we talking rock and roll?
100 shares of chance for steel. Hasn't moved an inch.
Of course it hasn't. The point of this exercise is to trade in stocks that have a pulse.
Blue chips are fine with me. I don't need any more risk in my life.
What risk? Look, you want to pay the kid's college tuition before he's born, you buy JDC.
Check it out. Internet stocks, all smoke and mirrors.
No, not all of them. My CPA represents a guy on the board.
I don't want to know about it.
Yes, right? You do, Fred. And do you want to know why? Because it turns out that JDC's fourth quarter earnings will be announced tomorrow. And unlike all the other fly-by-nighters, this stock is actually going to show a profit.
So, Johnny, you're still on top of the JDC?
Yeah, in a 15, 16, and 18.
You too?
In a 23.
Oh, I'm in a 22.
Sky's the limit.
Son of a bitch!
What'd I tell you? I mean, some guys just aren't cut out for this.
You know, we've been with Merriweather for 12 years, and we've been very happy. We wouldn't want to do anything that would jeopardize that relationship.
Oh, I wouldn't want you to. You can be sure my grandfather won't hear a word of this from me.
So, what? Is this Corey Granville some kind of a virtual bond man?
Oh, he'll be here.
Where else but Wall Street can a man make you millions? You've never seen his face.
The curse of an electronic society. Which actually leads me to the reason for this meeting. Wesley Industries has retained us to the best of their electronics division.
Wayne Wesley is unloading?
Yeah.
Never thought I'd see that day.
Yeah, we're actually dealing with his firstborn, Wally.
Putz.
Sorry, guys. The FDR was crazy.
There he is. Corey Granville meets Sam Rossi.
Face to face at long last. Sorry your brother couldn't make it.
So's he, I'm sure. His turn to tour the coast.
That's funny. I was just telling Sam here that Wesley feels its one Bangkok plant's not really compatible with its overall business plan.
Right. I thought it was profitable.
Oh, it is. Positive cash flow, 6 years running.
We're not in the habit of buying someone else's cast-offs.
Of course not. But with the predicted tax bill in Thailand, that'll offset your tab on the Hong Kong plant.
Interesting.
Ah, it gets even more interesting when you consider the integration of your computer parts division.
What are we talking?
10 times cash flow.
That's a hefty number.
That's all relative. I mean, think about what Worldwide paid for Hayashi.
Hayashi is a whole other ballgame.
Well, not when you consider the value of land in Bangkok. It's prime realty.
I didn't say we're not interested. We just like to see the numbers.
I think I will get that drink. I doubled their money. You'd think he'd at least look at me?
Welcome to the world.
The hell? Dit's known him for years.
When will you open those pretty eyes of yours?
Meaning?
The dollar bill is green and white. To guys like that, the only way you get into their club is to carry their golf bags.
That is ridiculous.
Why? Because you went to Harvard? Just because you bang white broads doesn't mean their daddies are going to invite you home to dinner.
I don't give a damn about complexion.
Really? How many black women have you been with since I dumped you?
I'm sorry, I don't keep score.
Maybe you should.
Excuse me. Excuse me. Way to go, bro. Did I see you at my house at Christmas?
Huh?
Did I see you at my house at Christmas?
Hell no.
You're not my brother or any other relation for that matter. Excuse me. Thank you very much.
Spouse, man.
My car's out front.
We'll get started right away.
Five star.
Water and so much land. The forests are not boundless. Well reserves, iron ore, coal deposits all have their limits. But someone will come to work this morning with a thought, and that thought will spawn an industry. If not today, then tomorrow. And tomorrow. In an uncertain world, you have this much. There's no bear market for good ideas.
I will never ask, what do you plan to do with your life?
I will never talk about the things you haven't accomplished.
I'll never bring up the time you came home smelling like that other dog.
I will never worry about where we're going.
As long as you roll down that window so I can pretend I'm flying.
No relationship is like the one with your dog. No dog food is like Purina One Brand. And it's made with real meat. No corners cut, complete in every way. For the health and happiness of your dog. Purina One, how great relationships are fed.
Channel 2 Action News and The Vote 2000 continue tomorrow, 5 to 7 a.m. Results from overnight on the hottest races. Tune in for the morning after wrap-up with the most complete election coverage. Tomorrow on Channel 2 Action News This Morning. Election coverage you can count on. Channel 2 finds out from the experts what's really known about cell phones and shows you which ones are the safest and which might not be so safe. Join Monica Kaufman and John Pruitt for a Nightbeat special assignment. Tomorrow at 11 on Channel 2 Action News.
Don't let your minutes go bad. Get Bell South Rollover, the only minutes that roll over to the next month. We also feature Ericsson digital phones, now at your Bell South Mobility store.
What'd you say your name was?
Frank Sullivan.
Dad?
John? John Sullivan?
says that he's talking to your son in the future.
We're all growing up.
Mom's gonna be murdered.
When?
October 12th, 1969.
There's tomorrow.
Tomorrow hasn't happened. But I gotta do something. Are you still there?
Frequency, rated PG-13.
Up to 25.
This isn't a roulette wheel, you know.
What, are you kidding me? I put this sucker out on the internet. Volume's through the roof. Why shouldn't we all drive Porsches?
All on unfounded gossip.
Well, you know, if it was unfounded, I'd be pretty dumb dumping every penny I've got into it.
You're kidding.
Well, my CPA's gonna lie to me. He's got what they call a fiduciary duty to his clients. Anyhow, close the business tomorrow. I will be officially retired, my friend. Off on my around-the-world cruise.
What's 75 fire in the history of my life?
We got him.
You're kidding.
Top of the ziggurat, bud. You were great.
Yeah, right.
I'm talking major fee if this thing goes down. Rossi's office, noon, we go over the numbers.
You know what I was thinking, Dit? Maybe it'd be best for everyone involved if you handled this on your own.
We don't actually have to like him to do business with him.
Yeah, well, I was wondering what happens if he doesn't feel the same way.
Yeah, high rollers, the fellas here before you.
Some kind of dot-com, I think.
Everything, top of the line, you know, till they went splat.
Oh, their bankruptcy was the only way we could afford a sublet on this place.
Oh, yeah, every cloud, huh? You hear what I'm saying? Sugar?
Flat line.
Freddie's going with Euro dollars.
Yeah, yeah, I heard.
So, the sugar deal, I mean, would it be worth me looking into?
Sure hope so, Denny. I sure hope so.
You have $4, and I'm telling you this is just the beginning.
Well, if Meriwether marks a boy before you know it.
Pam, we don't...
Please don't tell me the Kaiser's gonna make you work this weekend. We promised Marcy we'd come out to Montauk.
No, no. It's just...
So? What time is it?
Again?
If you don't like it.
Almost 6:30.
I'm sure you like it.
My God, you're here. And it isn't even Christmas.
It isn't. Oh, see ya.
Not before you pour us a Glenlivet, you don't.
No way. You keel over, I'm up all night with the Emmy's office and the cops. Who needs it?
Always thinking of yourself. How are you?
How is he?
How do you think he is? He misses you.
Well, he has a hell of a way of showing it. I left the business, not the family.
To him, there's no difference.
You know, you'd think he'd learn. I mean, after Dad tried...
Your father is...
Is your only son.
There are many things you don't know, Robbie. Now pour us that drink.
That's right. One thing this family is never short on. Secrets.
There are a million reasons why a man gives up on his life. Finding one to keep going, that's truly difficult. If you think your grandfather is somehow responsible for your father's condition...
I never said that.
Do you think I don't see the accusations in your eyes? Do you think I don't hear them in your voice? I will not have anyone, especially someone who owes him everything, accuse him in my house.
Where is...
sales of your Bangkok division.
Which rose every quarter over the past 6 years.
Well, our point, Mr. Wesley, is that your main moneymaker is beef. The cash earned from dumping the electronics division could be used to purchase, what, 50,000 head of cattle? Which will easily throw off 3 times the profit.
We already have a buyer in high tech who would be more than happy to toss 10 times cash flow your way.
They're happy, you're happy.
Everybody wins. Even you.
We're only expecting the standard 1% fee.
Yeah, which is French
for $1 million.
Yes, but it's the American way. Would you excuse me? I have to go call Detroit.
So if there's anything in our proposal that's unclear, Mr. Wesley...
Wally. Have you ever been to Bangkok, Allison?
For about 5 hours once.
Mm-hmm. Whatever your pleasure. That's what rules its economy. Men, women, boys, girls, any combination you please, and twice on Sunday.
It takes a lot more than talk to shock me, Wallace.
You're right. Talk bores me, too. I don't know, maybe the Thais have it right. They say that one night in Bangkok is all it takes to ease a troubled soul. What do you say, two of us take a little twirl? Dance, Miss Jeffers.
Ultimate Zone with the new Ford Escape.
Pull over once and shove in your pocket. How about one of those bear claws?
Hey, big spender. What? Did you pick the winner yesterday?
Round and third and heading for home.
Oh, that's good.
Still stalking me, rookie? Large the works, please.
Got it.
You haven't called me. Things must be going well at Merriweather.
Kid owns the street.
Good for you. You know, my offer still stands if you change your mind. Especially if this Bangkok deal we got cooking goes through. Might even be able to pay you. Got another pepper wall knocking around up in there?
As a matter of fact, JDC Tech. Fourth quarter earnings come out today. It's bleeding black.
Blue? You didn't read the paper yet, did you? Yeah. Hold on a second. There's the same page. Here we go. JDC, Jonathan Davis Carlisle, chairman of JDC Tech, right? Blah, blah, blah. Indicted 37 counts of bank fraud. Wouldn't worry about it, though, man. One out of two, it's a hell of a month. Boyd, keep in touch.
I missed you at morning call.
I missed you at dessert.
Something came up.
Yes, it most certainly did.
Do I detect some anger?
Anger? Yeah, sure, that's close enough. The fact that you even knew about a place like that.
Oh, wow. Come on. It's just business. Men like Wesley, they live large. Truth is, with faxes and email, we could close this deal over the phone. But still, men like Wesley come to New York expecting to find things that they can't find in Kansas City or Gainesville or Boston.
And your job is to show it to them?
Well, it's my job to close the deal, whatever it takes.
You don't have any business in Detroit. You left me as bait.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but you didn't leave. You could have very easily. But you chose not to. It's not me you should be slapping at.
Be that as it may,
Wesley's secretary called today and he wants to see us for dinner.
Are you surprised?
No, not at all. In fact, this is turning out to be a very profitable working relationship. Tell me all about it.
You want all the dirty details, do you?
Yes. The more lascivious, the better.
for me then. If you don't mind, I need to prepare for tonight's meeting.
How bad?
It's at 4, down 28. I knew I shouldn't have listened to that damn CPA. What am I, insane?
Lost over 6,000.
What are we gonna do? What can we do? Oh, God, I just lost everything. Everything.
Everything is about money.
I know I should have told you, all right? But it's hard, you know? Losing. It's like they took away my. A man is supposed to. That's who I am.
It's not. It's just a job. Hey, this is the apple, right? There's plenty more where that came from.
You don't know him?
Kaiser Smizer. The guy's an old gray goose, not God. Now, this guy rerun. Why don't you give him a call tomorrow?
You mean Ditto?
You call him first thing, okay?
Salary's not the same.
So you're getting into the ground floor. Things could be worse.
All over the wires. The market didn't react like it should have.
Hello? Am I talking to myself here?
How bad?
It's down a buck. I mean, it could be it's just a temporary reverse bounce.
What do you see?
Where?
When you look at me.
Well, if you're referring to what I may or may not have seen the other night.
No, I'm being serious. What's the use?
All I'm saying is if I saw anything the other night, it was perfectly normal. Better, even.
Corey! Come here. You got it, sir. Okay, take care. Bye. Rossi's a go.
Yeah?
You floored him with that tax offset thing.
He said that?
Well, he didn't have to. I could tell by the look in his eyes.
So that's what that was.
You want me to apologize for him? Okay. I am sorry. But the fact of the matter is we got rent. $1 million worth when this thing closes, and that makes me extremely happy. Ergo, as my partner, I feel it only proper that you be similarly tickled. So, my suggestion is we put a smile on our respective faces, we head down to Hartley's to celebrate, okay, by diving headfirst into a barrel of 12-year-old single malt. What say?
I'm impressed, kid.
Yeah, it'll do.
It'll do. Storefront on Jamaica Avenue will do. This, huh? It's a lap of luxury.
This is thanks to you, Greg. Right
there. Hey, your old man's been good to me, huh?
And he never knows.
Like I said, our business is confidential, right?
What the hell is this?
Don't let anybody ever say that I am not the best deal maker this side of the Mississippi. This 65% off.
It's Hayworth.
Birch.
Is what I am talking about.
I'm gonna give him a checkbook.
That's not exactly the way that Greg does business.
I don't want to know, do I?
Thank you.
No, it's a school night, Wallace.
To each his own.
Hell of a trip, Hunter.
As always. And thank you, Miss Jeffers.
Well, aren't you forgetting something, Wallace?
Hmm?
The retainer agreement.
Well, you don't give up now, do you?
So we got a firm offer from the Rossies. I don't see why this can't close within the month.
You people. Always in a hurry. Where you're off to, I'll never know.
Okay, Billy. Take them wherever it is they want to go.
Yes, sir, Mr. Wesley.
We'll see you next time. Sure, I'm gonna miss my nights in Bangkok.
I have a feeling you'll find a reason to return.
Billy, where you picked us up, we'll be fine.
Sure thing.
That went well.
You really are something, Hunter.
Yes, I am.
Three bold-faced lies.
Make one very expensive truth. See, the fact is, I learned a long time ago to forgive myself whenever I do something that's unforgivable. You should try it sometime.
You know, what the hell? You pulled a $100 million acquisition out of thin air. I am impressed.
Well, I couldn't have done it without your help,
Al. Yeah, somehow I think you would have managed. Well, maybe I will.
What?
Forgive myself.
Did you really have sex with him?
Would it matter? We closed it, didn't we?
Like this, or should I try an angle?
Do I look like Martha Stewart?
Point taken.
The sugar buy should have worked. I can't figure.
You know, that's why they call it gambling.
They don't call it gambling.
Maybe they should. And Freddie's pick for tomorrow? Sugar. Go figure.
Our heavy sales took the bottom out of sugar.
Well, you're welcome. thanks.
You're sure about the other transaction?
Yeah, 100%. Wesley Industries, some kind of divestiture. Wallace Wesley, he's meeting with Lasky.
It's got to be their electronics plant in Bangkok. Do they have a buyer?
Well, it looks like. I didn't catch a name.
Thank you, Dennis.
Well, hey, that's what you pay me for, right?
Keep up the good work.
You got it.
Call Wesley right away.
Sounds as if he's already retained them.
Not Wallace Wesley. His father, Wayne. And we're not buying the electronics division. We're buying the whole damn company.